Abdullah ibn Umar says, I saw a Yemeni man. On occasion I saw this Yemeni man. حَمَلَ أُمَّهُ وَرَاءَ ظَهْرِ. He had his mother upon his back. He was يَطُوفُ بِالْبَيْتِ. He was making tawaf of the Kaaba. So he was circumambulating the Kaaba. And he had his mother upon his back. And he was singing a poem. And as Abdullah ibn Umar is listening to what this man is saying. And what he's saying is, إِنِّي لَهَا بَعِيرُهَا الْمُذَلَّمُ وَإِنْ عُزْعِرَتْ رِكَابُهَا لَمْ عُذْأَرُ. That today for my mother I am like an obedient animal. And if anything was to try and scare me or stop me from being this, today I would stand steadfast. Meaning you would not be able to deter me. Then, this man comes to Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu anhu. And he comes to him, and in another narration it mentions that he comes to Abdullah ibn Umar and he says, oh Abdullah ibn Umar, tell me. حَمَلْتُهَا أَكْثَرَ مِمَّا حَمَلَتْ. O Abdullah ibn Umar, I carried my mother upon my back for longer than the period that she had carried me in her womb. Meaning above 9 months, more than 9 months. And he explains, O Abdullah ibn Umar, I traveled from the country of Yemen. I completed every ritual of Hajj with my mother upon my back. He says, tell me, أَتَرَانِي جَزَيْتُهَا. That Abdullah ibn Umar, tell me, have I completed my haqq? That right of responsibility and doing khidmah, of serving my parents, have I fulfilled that right? And listen to Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu anhu. He says, قَالَ لَا. He says, no, my brother. He says, وَلَا بِزَفْرَةٍ وَاحِدَةٍ. He says, you have not even completed that one breath that your mother had taken at the time of your birth. You have not even completed that. And I ask you this question. Tell me, have you failed your parents? Have you failed yourself? What is it that you want to achieve in life? Wallahi, have a dream. Have a dream that you want to achieve. But make sure that you do the khidmah of your parents. Make sure that you serve your parents. By only serving them, you will be able to attain that dream. I swear by Allah, that is the only way you'll be able to attain it. There is no other way. Every parent that will make their child an alim or a hafiz on the day of judgment, Allah will bless them with crowns. And people will look at them and ask, who are these people? What good have they done? In reality, when a person becomes alim or hafiz, what do the parents do apart from send them to madrasa? They don't really sit there and teach them, do they? But look at the status Allah has given them. That itself proves that Allah holds these people in high esteem. Even though you and me don't look at it like that. And what do we call our parents? Oh yeah, my old man, that my old woman. Or how dare you refer to your parents as old men and women? How dare you do that? Do you know that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam on occasion was with a group of companions, and he sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the distance saw an old and frail woman walking towards him, and he leaves the majlis of the ashab and the companions and he runs forth towards her. He takes off the top part of his cloak and he puts it on the floor. For whom? He didn't have a mother. Who was this woman? This was Halima radiallahu anha. Halima Sa'diya, the woman who had suckled the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He treated her like his own mother. That is respect. That is honor. And who was he? Rahmatulil Alameen sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He was the best of creation. Tell me, this man had more to do than you and I will ever have to do. He sallallahu alaihi wasallam had to preach this deen to every corner of this earth. And all you and me have got to do is respect our parents. And we don't even have time for this. And he sallallahu alayhi wasallam is showing us in practice that look, this is how you honor your parents. This is how you honor them. True men, true women will do this. It is those who fool themselves, these wannabe gangsters, these wannabe idiots and jokers, that will have nothing in the Akhirah. I tell you by Allah, the only thing you will leave with from this dunya is your kafan. The only thing you will leave with is those two pieces of cloth that you will be shrouded in the time when your janazah will lay here in one of these masjids.